Morning, everyone, and welcome to On the Couch with Rosanna Baptist Church. Hi, I'm Phill Sporton. Normally, I would have our senior pastor, David Bunnell, with us, but David's on leave this week. So we are delighted to have Professor Phill Batterham with us, who is our chairman of Deacons. Good morning, Phil.
Good morning, Phil. It's great to be with you and with those that are listening.
Yes, we're going to have fun with Phil and Phil here.
Absolutely. Phil squared.
Absolutely true. So Victorians are being asked who we are in the current situation, aren't we, Phil? What do you think?
Absolutely. We've moved into a very tough stage of lockdown, which is absolutely appropriate given the extreme situation that we're in. But it does pose challenges for people, and we've got a feel for those who are missing work and missing wages. We're thankful for some of the compensation that the governments are providing, but some people are doing it tough, and we need to recognise that.
Yeah, so our theme for today is who are we? And I think that is really relevant for Victorians today, because I think over the current period, over the next few weeks, we'll have a lot to say about just who we are.
Absolutely. I saw a commercial on TV featuring nurses, and they said, "We're not the front line, you are. You're the first line of defence." And I think we're being asked who we are. Do we care enough about the health and well-being of others to actually do what we're being asked to do? And the way in which that question gets answered, the extent to which we do care enough to stay home and to do all of those other things that are required of us will tell us, you know, who we are as a community.
Absolutely. The New Testament addresses who we are. What's your take on what the New Testament says about who we are?
Phil, I actually did a search of the New Testament, and I found that there's just an extraordinary number of things that it says about who we are as Christians. And we won't have a chance to go through all of those, but there are some, and I'll get you to give your thoughts. I think the starting point is that as Christians, we're people who've sought forgiveness for our sins. We've been forgiven based on Christ's sacrifice on the cross. And he therefore declares us to be a new creation. The word born again, or the expression born again, gets used in one part in 2 Corinthians 5:17. It says we're new creations. So that would be my first response. What about you?
Well, in the same vein, we're the home of the Holy Spirit. So my kind of view is that who are we? We are people who are accepting of all people. We are people who love our enemies. We are people who care for everyone. And we are people who claim to be God's children.
Absolutely. And in fact, in a couple of verses in the New Testament, at least three different places, it says that we're the children of God. In one place, it calls us the adopted children of God. Elsewhere, it calls us friends.
Yes.
And this is really quite mind-blowing when you think about the God of all creation, you know, the Jesus who died on the cross, the Jesus who rose again, and we're described as family or as close friends. It's an amazing thought.
And I think the other really important thing to remember is Christianity is not a privileged club. Everyone can avail themselves of being God's friend. It's open to everyone. It's not just a closed group of people.
Yeah. I attend a lot of graduations at the university, and when they're giving out degrees, they talk about rights and responsibilities. And I think that's the same thing as being part of the kingdom of God, being a Christian, that we have that right. God calls us his children, family members, but there are family responsibilities. And so elsewhere, Jesus refers to believers as people who would be the light of the world and the salt of the earth. So there are responsibilities to be involved in the family business. Yeah. So, Phil, there is another take on this question which comes from our Bible reading. So I'd invite you to bring the Bible reading to us.
Thanks, Phil. Well, off to the reading. Today's reading comes from 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 9 to 10. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praise of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Once you were not a people, but now you are the people of God. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy.
Thanks for the reading, Phil. There's a lot in that, and it's just two verses, but I think there's a fair bit to unpack, and we won't get through all of it. I wanted to focus on verse 9, and there are three expressions there that I think it would be good for us to discuss. The first of them is royal priesthood. What do you think that means?
Well, for me, royal priesthood gets down to the fact that we have a role, an obligation to minister to God and to our community.
Yeah, I think the word priest or minister in the Bible is synonymous with service. And I think we do have responsibility, as we talked about before we had the reading. We do have responsibilities that come with the privileges. And we have a responsibility to serve others, or as Jesus said in the Great Commandment, to love God and to love others. And at this point in time, with lockdown and so on, it's challenging to find ways to do that, but we need to be creative. We can't stop being God's people. We need to be creative in reaching out and showing love in ways that are practical and meaningful. So, second phrase, a holy nation. So the word holy.
I understand that to mean to be set apart, but I also think it's part of it is our obligation is to, in our service, it's all about our moral compass, doing the right thing before God and man.
Yep. And the third one, Phil, I just love. It says God's special possession. I'd use another word there and say cherished. And the notion that we are cherished by the God who made the universe, the God who sent his son to earth, who died and rose again, the God that worked miracles, that we are seen to be special, seen to be cherished by him is truly incredible.
Yeah, I absolutely agree. You know, that the God who created the universe, created all the stars. You go outside, you look at a blade of grass, there's billions of them, trees. That the God who did all that would cherish us. And what's also important when we think about that is that it's not a club. This offer, this being able to be cherished by God is available to everyone. All you've got to do is ask.
Yeah. I think there's something else that's implicit here when it talks about a holy nation. It tells us that we're not alone.
Mm.
So, you know, while we have this calling, we have this responsibility, we're not in it alone. We're in it with all of other gods, all God's other people. Collectively, we can do amazing things.
Yeah, the Bible is full of that sense of community, isn't it? And the importance of community.
Absolutely.
Jesus was not a me guy.
He was a me guy. No. So that's important to remember at times that we do feel inadequate. And often, you know, we've seen in this time many, many amazing things that God says about us. And there are many, many more that you could find in the Bible. But there are times then we just don't see it that way. And this week associated with On the Couch, I've placed a song by Lauren Daigle called You Say. And the you is God, what God says about us. And I find the song really uplifting. So I'd urge people to get into the scriptures and read what they say about us and to listen to the song. So Phil, in conclusion, I think you've got a good story to tell us from your open house experience.
Yeah, well, thanks for that, Phil. And it is a was a proud moment. And, you know, those who know, many would know that I'm active in open house, as are many of the Rosanna Baptist team. And being that we do get some level of government funding, modest as it may be, are we required to be audited by their various processes? And I remember one time an auditor came to visit us and asked of our team, what would happen if a Muslim come to the front door? And, you know, they were being a bit cheeky, I thought. Anyway, the young person who responded looked almost shocked and just said, we'd introduce them to the others, which I just thought was just a beautiful response and says who we are. And who we are is that whoever comes to our front door, you're welcome. It is our job as Christians to welcome all people and to love all. And very much, I thought, that was just a great example of that in action.
Absolutely.
Shall we pray?
We shall. Dear God, I thank you for everyone that's listening this morning. And I would pray for them. I pray for us. These are challenging times for our state, for our country, for the world. So, Lord, I pray that you would help us to look to you. You would strengthen us and keep us safe during this time. May we be wise and do those things that we're being asked to do to keep each other safe. May we have enough love, your love, to do that for each other. Lord, we do pray for those who are focused on our safety and care at this point in time, our government, for health workers, for police, for the ADF, for all that are working so hard to make this experience as safe for us as possible. Lord, I pray that you would help us to learn from this experience. We might emerge from the other side of this strengthened rather than weakened. Lord, we praise your name for your love for us. May we be conscious of you and your love in our life as we go forward. We pray that you'd bless us in the week ahead. May we be those priests that go out and serve, that spread the love and the news, the good news of Jesus Christ in our community. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Well, thank you, Phil, for joining on the couch this week. It's been a delight. And thank you, everyone, for joining us this week. And with that, I'll say bye for now. Thank you, Phil.
Thank you, Phil. And bye.
And bye. God bless everyone.
I keep fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure love. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know.